even without a run back for a touchdown, Devin Hester was ridiculous. I'm Steve Rosenblum. Deal with it. This is kind of where we came in with Devin Hester. When he showed up with the Bears, he took kickoffs and punts, and he ran them all the way back to the end zone. He became, in a word, according to Jeff Joniak, the Bears play-by-play man, ridiculous. And he kept getting more ridiculous. And he became the best there ever was. And so, of course, the last Bears management turned stupid and wanted to change that. They took the best punt returner, best kick returner in history, and they made him a wide receiver. He didn't know where to line up. He didn't have any feel for the position. He didn't read much. He pretty much went deep. That was it. They tried to sell him as a number one receiver. That might be the number one reason that both guys got fired. And now the new regime said he's not a receiver. He's a kick returner. He's a punt returner. That's all he did against the Vikings. 249 return yards on kickoffs, breaking his own franchise record. He didn't take one back for a touchdown. Still waiting on that. But he influenced the game so much. The Vikings got so scared of what Hester could do. They pooched a kickoff at the end. They set the Bears up at their own 34-yard line. And Jay Cutler directed the winning drive from there. Even without touching the ball, Devin Hester, kick returner, influenced the game. He has turned around field position again the way he did years ago when that's all he did was return kicks. He's doing it again. It's nice to have him back to ridiculous form. I'm Steve Rosenblum. Deal with it.